faves video. I don't think I've done one in a bit, so I know I was due for one. I've already done my current five favourite nail polish and blush, and those will be linked below for you guys who haven't seen it. But this one is my current five favourite eyeshadows, and I didn't really think I was going to do a video on this. I thought I was going to do a blog post and that'll be it, but I just thought I'll just do a video, why not? So I'm going to warn you, all these shadows that I'm going to show you are all like, they're either mostly matte, mostly MAC, and mostly neutral, because I've been really feeling very neutral shades right now. I've just been preferring to do a neutral eye and then a bold lip like I've got on today. So that's just been what I've been feeling. I think neutral eyes suit me better, especially with my eye shape as well, because sometimes I find that a lot of colourful shades will close up my eyes. So yeah, I've been really liking neutral shades. Okay, so I'm just going to get started and jump right into this. So the first shade that I have is Teta Tint. If I don't have like pictures in this video, then they're going to be like, I have definitely have swatches on my beauty blog, link below to the post. But this is Teta Tint. I've used this a couple times in some of my tutorials. I think the most recent one that I used it in was my Retro Red one, and this is one that I love so much. I've actually hit pan on it. It's my first like shadow that I've hit pan, because I use it like all the time. I like using it on its own, and I also like using it like mixing it with shades, because like with makeup I love mixing different things together to get like a new color or shade or whatever. So I love mixing this with other shades to like dampen it down if it's too bright or too shimmery, then I'll pop this one on top. It's a, I think it was described as like a caramel brownie kind of shade. I don't know, I guess it's like a fleshy kind of color, not my flesh color, but a fleshy kind of color. But I just really love this shade and I use it almost every day. It's one that you might bypass if you are kind of looking for new shadows, but I'd say, you know, if you're in a MAC store, whatever, MAC shop, whatever, just give this one a swatch and see how you like it, because this one is actually a surprise love of mine. I really love this shade. So the next shade is one that I've dropped many, many times, and this is MAC Texture. Again, a brown, as I said, I'm just going to be showing you browns. And this one has very, very, very slight shimmers in it. Which doesn't actually bother me, because I actually prefer matte shades. I think they blend a lot easier than other kinds of finishes. But this one is, I think it's matte with like shimmer, so it's not, doesn't bother me too much. So I like to mix this one with Teta Tint, and they go really, really well together. And I usually use this one on most days. In short, it's a really great colour, and it's, I guess, a staple, something that you kind of just need in your like MAC or eyeshadow collection. So yeah, so the next shade is one that is like a staple in my collection, on my eyes, my everyday routine, and it's MAC Swiss Chocolate. Now this shade, I use it just kind of like above my crease kind of, because I don't know if you can tell, I have very, very, very heavy eyelids, and my actual like lid space is bitty, bitty, bitty. So I need to create more of like a depthful dimension, because I just have like flat space here. And then, so what I usually do is I take the Swiss Chocolate on a brush, and I'll just take it just a bit over, and it kind of just gives my more depthful dimension or whatever to the eyeshadow look that I've done. It blends colours up. Like I use it as a blending colour. I know a lot of people use colours that are their same like skin tone, but for me, if I don't use this, I think that my eyes look a bit funny. So I love using this shade, and definitely will be a repurchase if I ever run out. All of these shades will be a repurchase, but yeah, definitely a staple. So this next colour is a dark brown, and it's Matte in Bark. I know a lot of people use this as their eyebrow colour, and I do use this sometimes, but I find that sometimes it can be a bit too dark for my eyebrows. But yeah, it's great as an eyebrow colour, but I wouldn't primarily buy it only to put on my eyebrows. I think that's kind of an expensive waste, I think. But I use it sometimes to kind of deepen up my crease a bit, because I don't actually really use black to darken up colours, because I think that might like just close up my eyes a bit too much again. I like to use this because it doesn't really, it's dramatic but not with like, it's daytime appropriate, shall we say. It doesn't darken up things too much, but it just adds that kind of enough darkness. I don't know if I'm making sense, but it adds enough darkness to your crease and it doesn't look too dramatic. There we go. So the next shade is actually a surprise love of mine, and it's Max Sable. A lot of people talk about this one, and I actually ordered a couple of matte shades this one. So a few months ago, I ordered like some matte stuff, and for some very odd reason, I don't know why, I didn't look at swatches online, which I usually do, but for this I didn't, and I'm actually really glad that I love this shade. It's, I don't know what finish it is, it's not a matte, obviously, but I don't know, I'll leave what it is somewhere on screen. But I just really love this shade. I'm wearing it today with Swiss Chocolate in my crease. But I've been loving this eye combo recently, and I wear it all the time because it goes really well with any sort of lipstick that I'm wearing, and I just really like it. So this, I really don't know how to describe this colour. In general, I don't know how to describe colours, but this colour is like a brown, a taupey brown. I don't even think I know what taupe is, but I don't know, I think this might be a taupe. But this is just to add a bit more of pizzazz to your eye look. So if I'm feeling a bit bored, or I've just found myself using the same thing over and over again, I will try and use this one, and I just love the look that I get with it. It just adds something a bit different and interesting for me anyway. I know it's all neutrals and stuff, but it just gives me more variation in my usual makeup routine. So I have been really loving Sable, and I say check it out. Check all these shades out that I've mentioned. So yeah, those have been my current 5 favourite eyeshadows. I'm hoping that maybe some of you have gotten a few ideas. Because a lot of you I know might not buy MAC eyeshadows, and you might want some ideas of stuff to buy or try. But so yeah, hopefully those gave you some ideas, and yeah, so let me know what you think. Do you have these colours in your collection? What do you think? And so that has been my current 5 fave. As I said, swatches will be on my beauty blog, link below, and I should hopefully get out a current 5 favourite lipsticks, and that should be the final like lot of video form current 5 faves. And as I mentioned in the last one, any like updates to my current 5 favourites will be on my beauty blog, and I think I might start doing like normal monthly favourites very soon on this channel. So yeah, that's everything, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!